to the danger zone.
Danger zone.
Why did we? Why are we? Top Gun came out.
The danger zone.
Top Gun came out weeks ago, Joe.
It was really good. Go see it.
Yeah.
Yes. I haven't seen Jurassic Park. I chose that over Jurassic Park, and I don't regret my decision. I do want to see Jurassic Park, though. Even though it's probably just going to end that franchise and begin the next, like, what is after Jurassic era? It's the Cretaceous era.
Ooh, Cretaceous Park.
They're going to, like, I know that's what they're going to do. This franchise is dead. Anyway, hi, everybody. Welcome to the PhazeCast.
Tyrannosaurus
it's me.
Rex.
It's him. We're here to talk about Miss Marvel. We're here to talk about Obi-Wan. We're here to talk about bullshit. Speaking of bullshit, I thought I was done with getting calls 5 minutes before my like arrival time at work because I'm not in the restaurant industry anymore. But don't worry, 5 minutes before we were supposed to start recording, Eric gave me a phone call to be like, "Where are you at?" I'm like, "What do you mean where I'm at? It's not time yet."
You need to start your poop sooner.
I can't control my bodily functions.
I can.
And another reason? You're a slave driver? And you should stop. Okay.
Listen, the reason why is because it gets
so hot!
It's Phoenix, man!
I was born and raised there! I know. It's not my fault that you don't leave your AC running overnight, so when you go do it, it's all nice.
It doesn't matter. Tyrannosaurus Rex is from the Cretaceous period, though, so, like, they were mixing
them
anyway.
Yeah, I know, but, like, they're just gonna... I think Stride Goofy was, like, one of the posters was, like, the end of the Jurassic era, and I'm like, oh. So they're gonna make more, they're just gonna call it a different park.
What about Jurassic Universe, and the dinosaurs are in space this time?
I want a crossover of Jurassic Park and Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, so that way they could be smart dinosaurs who in bodysuits running around fighting villains. That's the next movie franchise.
Like live-action Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles?
Yeah. Or you know what? Just give me a Street Sharks movie. Like, we're running out of ideas anyway. I'll watch a Street Sharks movie. That'd be dope as fuck. Anyway, welcome to the PhazeCast. I have to make a correction, Eric. This is my fault. Kamala Khan is not bisexual. I don't know why. I mistook her for another Marvel character. There's a lot of young teenage Marvel superheroes now, and I don't read Marvel inherently. I read DC more. So I just wanted to be like, she's not in canon bi, but that doesn't mean they might not change it for the show. But
we don't know yet.
To correct myself.
All right, I also have to correct myself from last episode. Yoshi from Super Mario is not Italian. I made that mistake.
Did you say Yoshi was Italian last episode?
I thought that he was definitely canonically Italian-American, but it
he's
turns out...
He's a fucking dinosaur.
He's
from the Mushroom Kingdom.
Yeah, he's from the Yoshi's Planet, not even Earth.
Yoshi's Island?
Yeah, New Yoshi's Planet. Oh, sorry, I'll have to make a correction next time about that.
I fucking hate you.
Moving forward.
I do see it, because I remember, like, when you're riding on Yoshi and you punch his head to stick his tongue out... He goes, "Gobble gooby!" And it's fucking...
Hey,
I'm canceled. Goodbye, everybody.
It's me, Yoshi!
It's me, Yoshi, over here!
Listen. We want to talk about Miss Marvel? Miss Marvel was good again.
It was
Episode 2 was good. It was good.
Uh-huh.
It's solid.
We got some... Okay, all right. Listen, buddy. Here's what I need from you for this episode, okay? Just because I'm calling him out, everybody. I'm calling him out. You were not awake last episode, and you need to be awake, because I woke up for this, motherfucker.
Well, let me tell you.
I don't care if it's Daddy's Day.
Let me tell you.
Not my dad. Go.
Let me tell you. I am not as enthusiastic about this episode of Ms. Marvel as the first one. So I'm sorry.
Why? We got more powers. We got creepy government stuff, and that's the government that was after Spider-Man and all this other shit in the previous Marvel shows. We have introduction of characters who will have powers soon, like Inhumans. That's who Cameron was. Spoiler alert, everybody.
The aspect of Ms. Marvel that I'm most invested in is the will they, won't they friendship plot of her and her friend and her interest in this new guy. I'm totally invested in that, but I don't care about these visions she's having.
She has hard light powers!
I know. I don't care. I'm sorry.
I hate you. I fucking hate you. God, do I hate you.
I just want to see if it works out between her and that guy.
Okay, so this is what I did. I think I do know. I think in comics, their will-they-won't-they relationship lasts a long time before they do.
Oh, yeah. And I mean, they're teenagers, so give them that time.
Also, he's moving.
Yeah, but that's the thing, man, is it's like, if she had paid attention to him, he might not have even wanted to do that. But you know what? You know what, man? Don't make decisions like that for people when you're fucking 15.
Yeah.
Go do your thing.
Well, I mean, they don't know. Like, they're his world is pretty much school, her, and apparently all the weird sci-fi things he likes, and also the fact that he continuously dresses like Marty McFly.
He kind of does, huh?
He literally had a vest. He had the vest this time in this episode. I'm like, you're just Marty McFly. With why are you dressing just like Marty McFly?
Because Marty McFly dresses fucking cool.
Listen, it's because he's the doc in the situation, but he wants to be cool. So he's dressing as Marty when he's really a doc.
He's really a fucking hermit old man who does science. Yeah, you know, there was a moment where he was like, what did he say? Because he had the tablet out and he was like, your powers are coming from inside of you, not from the bracelet. I was like, fucking how do you know that, man?
He's super smart. He's the smart guy. That's his thing.
But anyway, you know, you can't...
He's a smart guy to explain the bullshit.
You can't convince anybody not to make decisions in a knee-jerk way when they're... Because A, they're fictional characters and I can't talk to them through the TV like I can in Blue's Clues. And B... They're teenagers, so they're gonna do what they want.
Yeah, exactly. That guidance counselor is both funny and terrible.
I like he did the Meryl Streep thing.
Yeah, I'm Meryl Streep. You're like, how the fuck is this kid supposed to understand? What the fuck are you talking about, bud?
I feel like that's a good way to frame it for a kid, though.
Yes, except for the Devil Wears Prada reference. He probably never saw Devil Wears Prada.
Yeah, that's like a 15-year-old movie at this point, huh?
Yeah, and I don't think the 16-year-old dude who's into science is going to be watching, you know, especially in a world of superheroes.
they're like more interesting things
but
to watch.
But have you seen Meryl Streep's Devil Wears Prada? Out before you were born.
Have you been watching The Boys?
Are we switching to The Boys now?
Well, have you been watching it? Because we haven't even discussed The Boys.
We've never discussed The Boys.
Ever. And I didn't even think... Have you been watching it? Have you been keeping up?
I haven't watched the last episode.
The fifth one?
Yeah, but I heard it was pretty fucking good.
I kind of half-watched it last night. It was okay. Anyway.
I also really like Soldier Boy's actor.
Oh, yeah. Jensen Ackles? He's great.
Do you know why I like Jensen Ackles?
Because the first season of Supernatural is pretty alright.
No. Oh, okay. I've only seen like 4 episodes of Supernatural in my entire life.
Goes on for like only 15 4. Seasons. Nah, it's terrible, dude.
And under the Red Hood, Jensen Ackles is Red Hood.
That's right.
Jason Todd.
That's right.
That's why I like Jensen Ackles.
No, Jensen Ackles seems like a nice guy.
Also a very good actor.
And the way that he handles that character is pretty funny. Like, you should, when you watch the fifth episode, he does some like real fish out of water stuff being transported
I mean,
to the...
yeah, right?
Sorry, nobody expected spoilers for The Boys today. But...
He's the Captain America equivalent in The Boys, right? I think that's what they were going with.
Yeah, basically. I have a real love-hate relationship with The Boys. I think that people are always like, oh, don't read the comics because they're so fucking crass and horrible. And I'm like, the fucking show is that way.
The show's gonna start getting more and more worse, especially if Soldier Boy's involved. I'm just saying.
It's an at times unpleasant show. I think they deal with certain things in ways that I wouldn't. But I brought it up because you were talking about, like, that you know, he's not gonna see The Devil Wears Prada. It sort of reminds me of that. They don't do it, of course, in the Marvel Universe the way The Boys does, where they're, like, literally movies that, like, Iron Man is starring in, but, like...
Yeah.
But, like, they're clearly out there in a similar...
Ant-Man has a podcast.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, it's there. Dude, what if The Boys... What if Amazon exists in the Marvel Cinematic Universe and they have The Boys? Then, like, it's made purely as propaganda against superheroes by the government. Don't like superheroes.
And Ant-Man is evil?
No, Ant-Man's not evil. He's just a dad.
Happy Father's Day, everyone.
Happy Father's Day, everybody.
Dad, man.
Happy Father's Day.
Thanks. I He's I'm going to Chinese food. What do you mean technically?
Technically, I mean, is that incorrect? Is my statement wrong?
Technically makes it sound like I was just like, Bat, go do your thing, son. Be out in the wilderness and get raised by wolves. I raise him every fucking chance I get. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's out there, mm-hmm. and he's being raised.
I raise him every... He's out there being raised. Right now, I'm raising him. Fucking A. I wanted to talk about... her weird visions and how we immediately got that, not resolved, but, like, answered at the end of the episode.
Yeah, I wasn't expecting that.
That was crazy cool. How fast the government was to chase after her. Ugh. And the name Nightlight stuck. That's good. I am enthusiastic to see what direction they take the rest of the cinematic universe involving her story. Because Cameron, that guy... that she's, like, head over heels for, he's not an inhuman, but he has powers too later on.
Oh, is that, okay, that's why he was in the car at the end.
Yeah, yeah. Well, also, I don't know, I mean, her aunt, her person, someone's in the car, and that's Cameron's mom, and she's the one that he's been seeing in the visions, right?
Yeah, right.
Right. And is she evil? Is she good? I don't know.
I like that ended that way because of... well, I never finished Moon Knight, but I didn't finish Moon Knight because it was dragging so hard that I kind of lost interest. They went to, like, I don't know, some pyramid. I should finish it because I love Ethan Hawke, man. He's, like, one of my favorite actors.
It's good.
I know, it's not bad. It just didn't... I don't know.
Why am I on a podcast talking about Marvel movies with you if you're not into superhero movies?
I love shows. I love the movies sometimes. Sometimes
doesn't seem
I
like
just,
you're into superhero shows or movies.
So listen, listen. I have a real uh-huh. love-hate relationship with much of the Marvel stuff.
Uh-huh.
I also have a real love-hate relationship with The Boys.
Really?
Yeah, I don't know, man. I kind of hate watch that show. There are pretty large issues that I have with that show that I...
Are they issues that you're supposed to have because that's how the show is making you feel?
Well, I just feel like sometimes... Yeah, I think that is, to some degree, true. That it is supposed to make you feel some type of way.
Yeah. Because if you're mad at Homelander, you're supposed to be.
No, I mean, I totally understand that. I think that sometimes it's just a little over the top and it's like, shock value. Not in a way that's really that effective. It's just like, come on, man.
We watched Game of Thrones for how many seasons?
7 or 8? I don't even remember.
Yeah. Yeah. That's what that show did.
I'm there every week, man. But with Moon Knight, it dragged a little bit for me. And I think that I was talking about on TikTok, people discussing the fact that Disney Plus shows for Star Wars and Marvel are not really that episodic. They sort of structure them like a feature film.
And here's the thing. I saw your little TikTok there because you showed up on my feed and I don't like seeing you any more than I have to. And I was just like, I disagree with this take. I do.
Well, I think that when you look at something like WandaVision, right, and you're in the first, like, two episodes and the whole time you're like, okay, well, what's going to happen? I feel like what worked about Ms. Marvel doing that is that feels more episodic than most of their stuff usually does. You get a pretty big, significant cliffhanger. Because that's what TV usually does if it's episodic.
TV gives
like
you
that.
A significant cliffhanger every time.
Yeah, like pretty much every time. There's something to be like, well, what's going to happen there?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And Disney doesn't always do that.
I feel like they do.
No, not in WandaVision. Not.
Yeah, they did. At the end of every episode of WandaVision, like the first two, they weren't cliffhangers. They were just creepy notes about what's happening. And even though it didn't lead into the next story, it made you go, what the fuck did I just watch? I need to see what next episode's going to be like and what's going to happen.
Yeah, that's, you know, okay, fine. I finished WandaVision. I like that show a lot.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And so far with Ms. Marvel, we have the power reveal and her doing stuff. We're like, oh, we only barely saw her powers. I want to see her powers. And now with this next episode, we have, you know, getting to the car with new hot boy and his mom. And I don't know what's going on.
It seems like she's not going to be dating that guy after all.
I mean, in the comics, she did.
For a little bit. I want her to date her friend.
Eric has seen this as a teenage rom-com now.
Actually, I know. I'm totally invested in it in that way. No, actually, you know, when they sort of started putting in that, like, oh, well, maybe... Because I like once in a while when they have a show where it's like, maybe these people are just fucking friends. And that's all it is.
Yeah, maybe. Maybe. I mean, speaking of, like, Jason Ackles, didn't they, like, basically, like... I think he had a friend character in that. Because I think his character in the show was straight. But, like, right before... that his friend character died, he admitted he loved him, and then died and went to hell. Right?
In Supernatural?
In Supernatural, yeah.
I don't fucking know.
I thought you watched Supernatural. You made it sound like you did.
I watched, like, the first season when it, like, came out, because I had, you know, people who were like, oh, yeah, you should check that out, and then I watched it, and then...
Okay.
And then that show got bad. I mean, it was never good, but...
Immediately?
Yeah, like, pretty much immediately, actually.
Immediately? I think there's a whole fan base that's gonna kill us now.
Listen,
I don't see his views, everybody.
I don't share that.
I haven't seen Supernatural other than 4 episodes.
I don't think that Supernatural fans are out there, like, claiming that Supernatural is high art. It's one of those things where, like, if you like Supernatural, you're like, yeah, it's a CW show that's fucking crazy, but...
Yeah.
Like Riverdale, you know?
Well, Riverdale to me is a stupid ass concept with a stupid ass like that. None of that made it seem like, oh, you're gonna make a high drama show about Archie and his fucking friends, and you're supposed to no.
I heard they have superpowers now.
Yeah, that's so fucking stupid. I hate that so goddamn much. I don't want to talk about that. That's so dumb. Ugh. I want to watch Ms. Marvel episode 3 already. Now, Eric, just lead us in. You know you want to talk about this.
Obi-Wan Kenobi?
Yeah.
I want to talk about Obi-Wan Kenobi. Obi-Wan Kenobi episode 5 came out. It was really fucking cool.
Yeah.
It had the flashback. It had the Darth Vader tearing the ship. That was my favorite part of the episode. So there's a part in episode 5 of Obi-Wan Kenobi where Darth Vader goes in to the transport area where they're trying to escape.
He goes to the docking bay and they're escaping on a ship.
Right. And he pulls the ship down, and then he rips the fucking side of the ship off.
Like, fa, fa.
I feel like...
This is Vader in his fucking prime.
Yeah, it's really just an excellent show of his power in this episode. Mm-hmm.
I can't wait for people to be like, oh, only Vader has been ever been able to pull down a ship, even though people have been moving ships in Star Wars forever.
Yeah, that was that was a major plot point of Empire Strikes Back. Have you seen Empire Strikes Back recently, Joe?
Yes, I have.
Oh, you did? Did you rewatch it or something?
He raised it up from the yeah.
And
you
how did you
your eyes
How did you feel about How did you feel about Yoda in Empire
This
Strikes
is a stupid leader, and I'm not going to fucking fall for your shit, dude.
Yoda's not a Muppet, dude.
Yoda's a Muppet.
Yoda's not a Muppet.
Yoda's a Muppet.
Yoda, listen,
Yoda's a Muppet.
Yoda is puppeteered by Frank
Yoda
Oz,
who
is a Muppet master.
And who made the fucking puppet?
Well, in part, it
who
was...
Who made the fucking puppet?
In part, it was a creative designer from the Henson Company.
Oh, really? Was it? Crazy! You dumb fucking... And the way he acts, he's just a straight fucking Muppet, dude. I'm done with this conversation. It's over. We're talking about Obi-Wan. About Obi-Wan. So Darth Vader pulls a fucking whole-ass ship down, ripping out the walls, and then it's a fucking gimme, and the other ship behind it flew away, and he's like, fuck, shit, shoot, damn, I'm gonna kill Third Sister.
That was a good trick. I would assume that Obi-Wan pulled some force shit to make sure he didn't sense them in the other ship or something.
I mean, also Anakin is inherently, you know, a hothead.
Yeah, Anakin's kind of all over the place.
he's a hothead. I mean, we saw that in the flashback. Literally, he wants to be the best. He's excited about power and getting stronger. And that I like that we had a little scene like that where we framed that whole mentality for how Obi-Wan knew how they would act and how he knew Obi-Wan would act. It was very good.
I liked that flashback had a function beyond just being a flashback.
Fan service?
Well, no, it was a juxtaposition of his experience with...
I wanted it other than it to be a fan service.
Yeah, thing. Exactly. Because it served such a purpose in showing like where mm-hmm. Darth Vader is now and that he's it was cool because you got to see like how he is that guy now, sort of. You get to make that connection between Anakin and Darth Vader that you've never really had before. Yep. And that is pretty cool.
I mean, we kind of did have it. That's the whole point of the prequels.
Well, yeah, but I mean, you see it, like, right next to each other, and you can kind of relate, like, you're right, like, you can kind of relate how pissed off Darth Vader is to how pissed off Anakin was.
Even before he was Vader, he really liked doing the, I'm just gonna keep hitting your sword to the puppet move. He did. It's a sword, not an axe. I'm gonna kill you!
He's just a frustrated little kid, you know? He's like, why won't this work? I just hit you more!
The frustrated slave boy hates sand.
Yeah.
I saw the death coming, right? We saw, like, Sand Queen dying. I called it last episode. And did not expect the droid to die. That was sad for me.
That was sad.
God, he was protecting her, too. And then she has a fucking thermal detonator. The galaxy's quickest fucking way to kill everything in a room.
So, can I just say, and this is nitpicking, I'm sorry, but couldn't she have thrown that thermal detonator down the hall at least? Why did she have to
Let's throw dramatic? A thermal detonator at a Sith. That'll do a good job. That Sith won't catch it in the air and force push it back.
Well, no, she was just
with stupid moron.
She was just with stormtroopers at that point, right? Darth Vader wasn't there.
No, Reva was there.
Oh.
Dumb idiot. Stupid baka.
Hey.
Sorry. I'm sorry.
Hey.
I'm in a mood today. I'm in a mood.
It's okay.
It has nothing to do with you.
It's
I'm
okay.
taking it out on you. Although you didn't help calling me 5 minutes before showtime. Be like, where are you at? I'm fucking in the pooper.
Listen.
Leave me alone.
Just schedule your poops a little sooner.
I can't schedule poop to happen. I'm very regular. It's 2 or 3 times a day. In the morning, in the afternoon.
You know that some people don't poop that much?
I am shocked to hear.
I didn't
know. Someone told me I was weird because I'm like, you poop every day? And I'm like, you don't poop every day?
Yeah, no, people sometimes go a long fucking time.
How?
I don't know. That sounds really
uncomfortable. I don't understand. That doesn't sound right to
me.
That means your track is not working, in my opinion, right?
Well, I don't know. I mean, I looked it up because I was like, I think that means that you're going to fucking die. But it turns out, I guess, that there are just all kinds of different people.
Is it like a metabolism thing? Or is it just
I don't
like,
know.
Even science doesn't know? Is that what I'm being told? Because there should be a correlation.
I don't know. I don't know. But I poop 3 times a day.
I poop 3 times a day.
It's great.
Sometimes 4. If I, like...
wait, that's too many!
Well, I eat... The 4th time is if I decide to be like, I'm gonna eat something, like, disgusting. And my body is just like, what did you do? Stop it. Like, this morning for breakfast, I had avocado toast. You know, that was pretty good. I'm gonna make some pasta later today after going to the grocery store, yada yada yada. I plan my meals out pretty well. So when I stop going away from the plan, that's when shit goes crazy. Because for some reason yesterday, I woke up late, and I had like just a bowl of cereal for breakfast. And then I was out and about on town, and I saw that there was, like, some street tacos. And by the way, street tacos in Colorado Springs? I shouldn't have said yes, because that dude was white as fuck. I mean, I don't want to be that guy. But, like, you know what? Like, I looked up his, like, food truck. I'm like, he's got good reviews online. I want to try it. I haven't had a street taco in forever. So I bought, like, 3 street tacos. They were overpriced for no fucking reason. Like, they were $12 for 3 fucking street tacos. Like... street tacos, like, fuck this dude.
You can't even trust good reviews. You can't trust reviews of Mexican food.
I can't. No, I can't.
You can't.
Especially, unless you're...
Not coming from Arizona. Not coming from Arizona. Would you, like, that, I was just saying yesterday, that's, like, one of the best things about Arizona, dude, is, like, around Christmas time, you just walk around, and there'll be, like, a lady who's, like,
selling...
Tamales! Yeah, she's in, like...
Give me that shit, dude! I buy so much!
She's in, like, the Walmart parking lot yelling at you about tamales, and then they're somehow, like, the best tamales you've ever had.
Yeah, because homemade shit's always the best.
Yeah.
It's when there's no heart in anything, or where they're trying to get too fancy. Anyway, I just wanted some fucking carne asada tacos, right? I went to the bathroom extra that day a few times. And it would come out of nowhere. I'd be doing fine. All of a sudden, I'm like, oh. And I'd have to run. And then it's just, it's not solid at all. It's just...
Oh, God damn it.
And then it's... You asked! You did this!
I don't think that I asked.
You kept on saying, schedule your poop! You brought this to this level. If you wanted anything else from this, you shouldn't have kept bringing it up.
Nobody's so gonna watch up. This.
Good. Good. Don't. Anyway.
Yeah, so that was a four-time day?
That was a four-time day.
Yeah. You know... Never mind.
Yeah. Yeah. So to answer your question, Eric, no, she didn't throw the thermal detonator because there was a Sith there.
Yeah, you know, I guess you could probably, you're right, you need to have control of that shit.
Also,
can you deactivate thermal detonators if you grab them and press a button real quick?
No. They just go. Also, thermal detonators are like kind of last resort. You don't want to just throw one and then, like if you throw it and then... What would happen? You'd kill, like, a bunch of the early stormtroopers, and then there's still, like, 1,000 more behind that door, because there was a bunch there.
Yeah, I guess you don't want to risk that. I feel like she could have recovered from that wound.
No, see, a gut wound
but
in
she
Star
been,
Wars...
But she would have been caught, too, so, like...
Listen, a gut wound in Star Wars is either A, fatal, or B, I'm gonna come back in a few episodes. Hello, the Grand Inquisitor!
Doesn't really feel fair that Darth Maul got chopped in half and got robot Lift. Legs, and Qui-Gon got a little midriff stab.
He got a midriff stabbed, and I think he was also... No, that's it, yeah. Qui-Gon's a bitch. I'll say it here. I've said it before, canonically. Qui-Gon is not that good of a Jedi. I don't know why people suck his dick so much.
It's Liam Neeson, dude.
So what? That doesn't mean... Everyone's like, Qui-Gon is one of the best Jedis of all time. I'm like, really? What did he do in the movie he was in? Because he did just, nothing but fail
he's just
in
got
the
a,
movie he was
he's
in.
Got a, yeah, I know. He made some real bad decisions. He's just got a voice that's like so like authoritative
you want
and soothing
to free
at the
same
boy. Time.
No, I don't. like you just... Oh, your force trick didn't work? Good job,
listen,
bro.
Listen.
Fuck. Nothing. Oh, you lost to Darth Maul? While your Padawan fucking took him? Good job, bro! Fuck!
You took a child away from his mother so that he could become space... Satan?
Well, he's space equalizer in the end.
Space equalizer.
I mean, he did. He left everything equal. And then it got bad.
Liam Neeson has a voice that is at the same time authoritative and soothing. That's what it is.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But as a Jedi, he was trash. I'm gonna just say it. He should. I don't know how. Honestly, Anakin should have been master compared to him. Fucking.
They do not grant him the rank of master.
They do not grant him the. You may have a seat on this council, but we do not grant you the rank of master.
They don't.
What a fucking dick move.
they gotta save that shit for Yarl Poof.
Yarl Poof.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The stickhead.
Yeah. But no, I want to talk about Reva's motivation, because that was such a good swerve. That was such a good swerve. Oh my god. Having like her go up to the door and do a weird force conversation / whispered, stop picking your hair, bro.
I think there's something in my hair.
Having a good whispered conversation with Obi-Wan, like through the door, and then Obi-Wan finding out you were there during Order 66, he was there. And it was, Reva wasn't hunting Obi-Wan. She was just getting the perfect bait so she could fucking kill Vader. Dude.
I thought it was a great dynamic that that they could not... They still could not find common ground there, really.
They did end up, though. They did.
Yeah, she but it wasn't just a simple team-up, you know?
No, it wasn't. To be fair, she is corrupted by the dark side of the Force.
Yeah, corrupted by the dark side, blinded by her rage, you know? Good stuff.
Yep.
It was a interesting dynamic there between her and Obi-Wan, because I thought for a second it was like, oh, they're gonna now they're gonna fight him, but like, of course they don't kill Darth Vader.
No.
So
Obi-Wan did nothing but defensive moves again. Sorry, I know this is not what I initially said, but I'm just thinking about the hallway scene. All of it was just defensive and like knocking stuff back. It was such a good acknowledgement of how that character fights. I love it when when a character comes out through their like. Especially in action movies and kung fu movies, swordsman movies? I don't know. Fighting movies, warrior movies. Like, seeing how that person is mentally portrayed through their fighting style is just fucking top tier for me.
Yeah, that's when you know you got like a good movie on your hands in that genre.
Or at least a good fight director.
Yeah, that's, well, yeah, but I feel like you don't have to do that, really, to make an action movie. But when you do, I mean, it's like Bruce Lee, you know?
Yeah.
Like, you know what that guy's about the second he starts throwing hands. Yep.
The second he starts fighting, you're like, oh, that's his style. Okay. Yeah. Okay.
It's like that, you know? You get a good sense of the character from it, for sure. And it was cool to see him getting more comfortable with the use of his lightsaber again.
He just got better and better throughout it.
Mm-hmm.
Leia takes forever to find a red wire.
Listen,
Leia took way too long.
She's 10, dude. The fact that she was able to do that at all.
Fair. Fair. I love that we got Haji back.
Yeah.
That was great. Great to see him.
Yeah, more, that's fine. It was
all
right.
Why did he hand him all of his stuff just so he could drop it? That was the stupidest thing.
What did he do? What did he do?
Obi-Wan handed him all of his stuff, like, here, take care of Leia. And then he left. And then he's like, Leia, hurry up. And then when they're leaving, he drops Obi-Wan's, like, communicator. His intergalactic communicator. And why did Obi-Wan even hand him shit? Just so that could happen?
Wait, there was a thing that happened at the end that I forgot about. And it was that Reva was sitting...
Stop! It's just my fucking hair!
It's just my shiny hair. Reva was sitting at the on the ground because she had been stabbed. And she grabbed the thing and something happened. I don't even fucking remember what it was.
But she grabbed the intergalactic... The thing I just talked about.
Right.
Son of a...
No, I know. That's what jogged my memory.
That Haji dropped. Yeah. So Haji was handed stuff only to drop that one thing and for her to grab it.
But then it showed something. What was it?
Didn't show anything.
Yeah, it did.
No, she just had it.
No, it was something important.
No, nothing was shown. She just had it in her hand and that was the cut. I'm pretty sure.
I don't know. I think that it...
Well, you look it up while I talk about how Vader was a badass.
All right, tell me about Vader. Tell me about Bader.
Bader? About Bader?
Tell me about Darth Bader.
It's Vader. His name is Father. And it's Father's Day. So you need to shut the fuck up and respect him.
Young Vader.
Fucking one-minded, solely focused on one thing, Darth Vader. Where you think he's actually going to get hit a little bit. I didn't think he was going to, he wasn't going to lose, obviously. But I thought Reva was going to get a swing in. Nah.
Yeah.
Vader played her. He owned that. Goddamn fiddle. He didn't even turn his own lightsaber on. He did half the fight. He didn't have a lightsaber. He would just stop it with the Force, and he was like a Shaolin monk.
Yeah. He was just going like,
He fucking split her saber in two, and then was like, I turned too much. Come on. Just completely embarrassed her. Fucking ran circles around her. Fucking took her to goddamn town.
Yeah, that entire sequence and then leading up to the Grand Inquisitor returning was like just... They were like, let's make her feel silly.
Yeah.
It was fucked
up.
Which
makes me think maybe that... They just stabbed her once and left her to die, which is like, oh, Vader is definitely using her still.
Yeah.
Somehow Vader's using her, and I know it, and that felt real good.
Well, so let me tell you. So what it was at the end was that the communicator has Bail Organa on it, and he mentions Luke.
Oh, that's right, yeah. Well, he mentions the boy.
Yeah, as the boy, and then he's on
Tatooine.
Oh, and
then the cutting shot, sorry. Everything else was cool.
Luke,
I did not care about the cutting shot of Luke, yeah.
Yeah. So, but is Reva going to go for Luke? Probably. I guess that'll probably be how she actually dies, is that she will do that independent of Darth Vader, so Darth Vader will not know, but Obi-Wan will have to get back to Luke and protect him the way that he does.
Yep. Are we going to see Luke and Leia meet and then not remember it because they were kids?
Oh, God. Oh, God.
I'm just saying.
You're probably right.
I'm just saying.
If he goes straight there...
He wouldn't just go. He can't go to Alderaan. There's no going back to Alderaan until he deals with all the threats.
And isn't Bail Organa, didn't he mention in that video that he was going to go to Tatooine? Yeah.
Yeah, if he doesn't hear from him. And it's been a few days, too, already.
Yeah, so he has to go back to Tatooine immediately. Oh, my God, they might meet. They'll be like, hi, I'm also a little kid. And then they'll just go their own ways.
Yeah, or they'll be running away from... Well, I don't know if Luke will see a lightsaber. Luke should not see a lightsaber at this point.
Yeah, because he has to sit there with Obi-Wan later and be like, what's this thing? Blah, blah, yeah. blah. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
mm-hmm. Or Luke could just be a dumb kid, which, to be fair...
But I was going to go to Tashi Station to get some power converters!
Yeah, he's a whiny little bitch.
That's the kind of thing where people are like, ugh, I wish the acting were better in this Star Wars thing.
No, it was good. That was good acting. That was him being a teenage kid who wants to go to the Tashi Station and get some power converters with his fucking friends. You've never seen a teenager whine before? That's what it looks like. It's not cool. I've
been a teenager whining. I don't really remember it.
I do. It was annoying.
I don't remember.
I do. It was annoying.
You think that Obi-Wan has a good poop schedule?
I specifically was talking about you whining was annoying.
Yeah, you were there for that. Yeah, that's true.
I was there when you were a teenager whining.
That's a good point.
It was annoying. I was there when you were a young adult whining, and it was annoying.
That's a fair point. You were there for that.
God damn it, Joe. I really liked this white girl, and all you did was really talk really loudly about the fifth element. The most annoying text ever. I'm like, what the fuck? This little brat.
To be fair, I was pretty drunk. I was like, when that specific thing that you're talking about happening, I don't even remember that happening.
Oh, that was hilarious. I just remember I was driving her home, and I'm just like, why am I getting a text about this?
That was
that was a lifetime ago, my friend.
We were chased from a party by the police.
No, that was a different instance. That was a different instance.
Both of those times I was... Wait, I did not...
Yes, he was. Both of...
When you're talking about those sorts of things, I think that the issue there...
The issue?
Is that I don't fucking remember them at all.
I choose to ignore and not remember.
Listen, my question still
is: Obi-Wan poops regularly?
Yeah, I don't think that he does because he's living in a fucking cave.
I mean, what does he eat? Does he just eat
portions?
Crate dragon meat? No, he does. He had a portion. He did. You're right. He did the whole. I want to eat that because that's a practical effect.
It looks tasty.
I don't know if it looks tasty. I just want to eat it.
It looks like it'd be a little bit gamey, but then I'd be all right with it.
It looks like bread, but
no, it's like it's a little meatloaf.
Is it?
I think it's
meat. I always thought it was bread. I thought it was bread.
Oh, wait, are we talking like the crate dragon portions?
No, portions.
Oh, where?
No,
oh,
remember, because he had the little tin too, where he poured water and it.
Yeah, the Ray thing where it goes.
Yeah.
I think that, I think it's like, you know, peasant bread. I thought you were talking about the crate meat. That shit looks delicious.
No, I would eat, I don't know if you can eat that raw. Probably not.
No.
It's probably not sushi grade, but, no. And it's red meat. But, I would definitely sear it and kind of tartar it a little bit. Mm. You know? Mm-hmm. A little SMP. It's good meat, probably. It's probably really high quality meat, so you only want salt and pepper on it. Nothing else to bog it down. Just to taste that.
Yeah, and then you want a side portion.
Yeah. Of bread. Portion bread. And you put it on top.
One quarter portion.
Steak sandwiches.
Yeah, that actually sounds delicious. All right, anyway. Is there anything else? Closing thoughts on Obi-Wan Kenobi episode 5.
What do we think's going to happen?
I think exactly what I said before about, I think that Reva is clearly going to go for Luke on Tatooine. Obi-Wan is not going to know that that's happening, but he is going to go back for Bail Organa and find Reva there stalking Luke or whatever, and he'll have to kill Reva, I think. They'll have a real emotional showdown.
I want it to, and here's how it's going to happen, right? It's going to be the thing where he's going to be away from them, and it's when he fully becomes the master again, right? And this is going to be him owning up to a mistake, because Reva's situation is directly because he failed Anakin. She even mentions that in episode 5. How you didn't even realize your Padawan was this monster, and because of that, like, everyone I knew and cared about died. Like,
yeah.
Boom.
No, it's going to be a real emotional thing.
Very reminiscent. I think it'll be very reminiscent of the Rebels fight scene. Probably not as fast, but between Maul and Obi-Wan, where it's just going to be him being the stalwart defender, finally back at his full power, knowing his place and knowing that he needs to be on guard to protect this child against a monster of his own making that he feels sorry for. And when he does stab her in the gut again, and that will be the... You don't get two gut stabs. Two gut stabs means you're dead in Star Wars.
Everybody gets one.
Here's how the shot's going to be framed, I believe. She's going to be stabbed, then she's going to fall, and then he's going to catch her, and he's going to hold her like this. Because every single important death that involved Obi-Wan, he's held them like this. He did it to Qui-Gon. He did it to Satine. He did it to Darth Maul. Like, he holds them and talks to them in their dying breath. Or as they're already dead, he just kind of holds them and, like, thinks about everything. And then he takes that with him when he moves forward. But I still want a Vader fight. We didn't get it. We didn't get a Vader versus Obi-Wan fight, and I don't know if we will at this point.
Yeah, I'm not sure if we will either. He can't go back to Tatooine.
Unless, I mean, Vader could go to Tatooine just to follow Reva, or to see if, like, oh, Reva knows something. We're going to use her to find Obi-Wan.
Yeah, he might have to get through Darth Vader first.
He might not know what that is.
Yeah, that's, right? Yeah, you know what? All right.
Because he's not going to care about his, cousin Owen, brother, half brother Owen,
half brother. No,
no, it's just married into,
yeah,
right?
married stepbrother.
He doesn't give a shit about Owen or Beru. He doesn't give a shit about them.
Yeah,
he doesn't know them.
I don't think that, yeah, and I guess you're right that, like, you know, the Grand Inquisitor and Darth Vader are not done with Reva. They wouldn't just leave her there,
nah,
you
nah.
know, if they were
that's
done
not how
with
they
her.
Operate, yeah. Especially because they literally, like, the Grand Inquisitor shows up, I'm okay from a gut wound. Yoink.
I love that
Here's
guy's...
gut wound.
I like that guy's voice. Rupert Friend's take on the Inquisitor. He's got a real, snivelly Empire voice.
I don't want a snivelly Empire.
I know.
Utapauan.
I'm into it,
the
though.
Rebel Utapauan. You should see him. He was great.
No, I mean, I know.
Someone also pointed out... that Powans have two stomachs.
So he got stabbed in one stomach?
Yeah, only one!
He's like,
I got a second one!
You
baby!
You did not hit my backup stomach. I also think, I'm calling it again, Qui-Gon is going to be there in some capacity.
At the end. And I don't think we're even going to see Qui-Gon.
Yeah, it might just be his voice.
Obi-Wan. And that's all it is. It's going to be an audio clip, too. It's not even going to be...
No, same as Obi-Wan talking to Rey for a second a couple times, you know?
Yeah.
It'll be that kind of thing. It's gonna be great. I'm so fucking stoked. I'm so psyched.
It's almost over already. It feels crazy that it's almost over. I've been hyping this up for a while. We have a lot of Star Wars content to come.
Yeah, a lot.
Yeah. But still, I'm... Yeah. I don't have my second screen up, so I don't know how long this episode's been running. But I think this is a good place to wrap it up.
Yeah, it's 44 minutes. It's almost exact. You know what I said?
Fuck yeah.
When I said chased out by the police earlier, it conjured up an image of us running from, like, Sting and his band.
Sting the wrestler?
No,
oh
not
my
Sting
God.
The wrestler. Sting the musician.
And then it's the man with the mask. He's got the bat, and he's chasing us. And we're like, oh, fuck.
No, the police. Like, you know, Stuart Copeland and Sting and the other guy.
Oh, the police.
The police. I said the police. And I thought to myself, that's not really how
whenever someone brings up that Sting, I always think of my Sting.
I know, you get the wrestling Sting.
Then I think of him in the band Police.
Well, next week we will be talking about different versions of Sting. Episode 5, Episode 6 of Obi-Wan
Summer
Kenobi.
Beach Boy version. Then his Raven fucking the Crow version. And then his new AEW personality, where he's just great to see. It's weird seeing, like, a 60 to 70-year-old man jump off of a balcony onto some tables where people are at because I worry for that man's safety because I love him and I don't want him to die. But I'm going to watch it every time.
We all die, Joe. And then there'll be a face point after that. Who knows what it'll be.
Memento mori, remember you will die.
Goodbye, everybody.
Goodbye.